okay, baby. You cool. Do what you want. I give you your release. You're free.
Y'all doing? Y'all know I'm in San Antonio. Don't find a car to park a lot pimping in. Y'all know how I do. I'm gonna wait a little bit, let some more folks log on right quick. I see y'all logging on. Cause y'all know we get ready to get real. What's up, Snoopy? Mm. What's up, Sheila? What's up with you, baby? There goes Snoopy King.
That's my man, Snoop Dogg. That's your man.
What's going on? Make sure y'all share this real quick. We'll give y'all a minute. Go ahead and share. Because we going there. Oh, Lord. Oh, that's your hat, baby. That is your butt. Because she's on the live. Go ahead and share. We'll wait.
Nobody scared of
Cheryl.
That's your mama, not mine.
That's right. But you already know what she told you. Yeah, she already told you on the last time you was on the live. Go ahead and share the live with you y'all the time. Look. She already told you, and I know. What's up, John? Make sure you go ahead and hit that share button real quick.
Who mama is it?
All I know. What's up, Ron, baby? All I know is going to get real, real. We are coming live from the chocolate ball, but you know how I do. We don't hijack somebody's car because y'all know we don't have a car. So we don't hijack those one. So go ahead and share this live real quick because I got questions that I need answers to. It don't matter where I am. No matter what state I'm in. If I can find a car and I can find somebody to kidnap to put in one and park a lot pimp real quick. What? Are you serious? No, I asked you before we started. Was there any questions out there? And you told me no. Seriously?
You funny. Now we good.
Go ahead and share this live real quick. Because I want him to walk it like he talking. Hmm. That's what I want you to do. You scared? You ain't scared to be in the car with me, are you?
What can you do to me?
I don't know where I'm going.
Okay, well, we're
going. I'm in another state. I don't know where I'm going.
I don't even know where we at, so we rolling
okay,
together.
Okay, well, we cool. Then y'all ready to go ahead and share. Because we get ready to get real. Because I'm about sick of you. I'm real sick of you. Are y'all sick of him? Thank you, John. Oh, snap. Because this is ready to get real. It's 197,000 degrees here in San Antonio. And I'm real upset today.
Now, you just made it 200,000. With you being hot in any weather, it's 200,000 degrees.
I'm just saying. Let's get this thing started. Doctor, are you ready, baby?
Help!
You born ready.
They said you gotta stay ready so you ain't never gotta get ready. I'm ready.
All right. I'm going straight in the thing you told me not to talk about. The goddamn contest. Look at him. You're in or out. Because Cheryl said you can't be in. You saying she ain't your mama. All this stuff. You're in or out.
I'm in.
Oh, you Cheryl? Did you hear this? He said he gonna be in it anyway. All right, listen.
Let's go.
Why are you in the contest? Why do you want to get? Because you did make a good point. When I asked you, why do you want to be in the contest this year? You did have a very, very valid point. Now, Cheryl, listen at this. Make sure you listen at this. Why do you want to be in the contest this year?
Because I want to compete in New School, a category I never competed in. That's why.
So he want to be in new school, Cheryl. So, hey, Gino, so maybe you should not be so hard on him. He wants to do new school this year. So that's a category that he's never done before is new school.
And I want to do walking.
Don't do walking. Okay.
By next year. And then the master's and I'm done.
All right, Cheryl. How do you feel about that? So he wants to do new school this year. And then he wants to do walking next year. We wait for Cheryl to approve this.
Hold on. Wait. Let me see. I think my birthday say 11/12/63. That means I'll be 55. That means I approve me.
I'm just saying, Cheryl. Okay. He wants to do.
She gonna write a book.
He wants to do new school this year, walking next year, and then the master's after that. So that's why he wants to compete this year. All right. So now you have a lot of stuff to say about people teaching classes. Now, you say a lot of stuff offline. I want you to say it online.
I said people No, I'm finna tell you. I'm not a big fan of people teaching that don't know the dance, that don't know the history of the dance, that can't break down the dance on both sides where the students understand what they should and shouldn't do. Yes, I say it. There's a lot of new faces out there that's teaching. And people get misinformation.
Okay, so riddle me this. You know what? You know what I'm going to say.
I don't know.
But when you say people give misinformation.
So you, for instance, you might have somebody say, yeah, I'm teaching, but I'm just doing the basics. I'm just teaching the basics. Well, hell, that's the most important part of the dance. Because if that's wrong, now the whole dance is wrong. Right?
Correct.
Okay.
But here's where the concern is.
Where's the concern?
How do you determine what's right versus what's wrong if it has never really been put to paper?
Let me see. I'm just trying to use an example of an instructor that me and you might know. And I'm trying to see if you would spend your money to go there. See, I know you don't know everybody in Chicago, but I'm trying to think about Atlanta. Matter of fact, y'all got y'all got people that teach in Atlanta that you wouldn't spend your money with, right? Tika officially left the building, y'all. Tika has left the building. You left the car, and you left the car running. I'm not mad at the people that are teaching the class. I ain't never mad at them. If they got a big following, a big class, hey, I'm happy for them. But when them people in the class go out and see that what they was learning ain't coinciding with what's happening out there, they the ones be mad.
But see, this is the thing. You can't, So when I saw this dance.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know what the dance was,
right?
So I'm new. I saw R. Kelly. Mm-hmm. You know, that's how most people kind of get introduced to stepping, right? So they see the video. They Google Chicago
and
stepping in my area.
And guess what? You saw R. Kelly and you wanted to Google. And the dance looked nothing like the video.
Not at all.
Okay, then.
All right, so you find a class, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you go to this class and they're teaching you the basics, mm-hmm. Okay. It takes a while before you really see it differently.
Well, here's me. I research anything I'm going to do. So if you was teaching a class, I'm going to look you up. I'm going to see what you're doing, how you teaching, and see if that's something I like. And
but
hold on.
But you don't know what to like. You're
listen,
new.
Listen. Okay. I'm going to see if you're doing something I like. But also, while I'm looking you up, there's going to be tons of people on videos that's teaching. And y'all all might have the different things to do. So I got to find what fits me.
But if you're new, you don't know. Going. Okay. We don't know what. You understand? Y'all understand what I'm saying? If you're brand new, you don't know
okay,
what looks
right. You were brand new, right?
Right. And it took a while
wait.
To know.
How long was the ride for you?
Damn near 2 years.
And then when 2 years passed, what did you find out?
That this don't look right. This ain't right. And I felt like somebody needed
so when did, how did you find out it wasn't right? Did you go out? Or
I saw some videos and stuff, and then I started to, you know, get myself more acclimated.
You started
to travel, and like, wait a minute, they look a little bit different than what I'm doing.
You're doing what I said doing in the beginning. Research it and look at it.
But you wouldn't know to do that in the beginning. So what my point... No, you wouldn't.
When you're spending your money, you don't go to the jewels because they got eggs on sale. And go over there and get your marriage. When little Johnny got a store down the corner, got the same eggs, where you going? Well, who you spending your money with, jewels or little Johnny? Because you don't know nothing about little Johnny eggs, but you know jewels have dozens and dozens and thousands of eggs in their show, right?
Because
they're credible, right?
But these people sell Okay, wait
yeah,
a minute.
They
wait,
do sell themselves.
They sell themselves. Don't let them have some digital flyers and some t-shirts. Because when you go to these places, they got t-shirts for sale. They got some jewelry on them. That means you straight up legitimate.
It's a lot of them people out there right now that can sell. I mean, they'll sell your jaws. You know what I mean? Yeah. If you got to check, you think they sell
them. So how do we know that this is the right class versus the wrong class, or versus, you know, teaching it right versus teaching it wrong, is my question. If you're in another area, now think outside of Chicago, y'all getting it.
Well, see, here.
Right, there is a big disconnect. You just don't know from right from wrong.
Okay.
And
here's where you can get it right, period. If you see it in your area, you're there and you question it, get your butt on the plane and come to Chicago.
That's always y'all's answer.
Hold on. Where's the dance? It's our dance. R. Kelly, the only thing he did good for this dance is did the video that didn't look like the dance, but when you stepping in the name of love, that got people involved in stepping. So when they saw stepping, what did they see it at? Chicago. That ain't always down. That is the answer. Come home. Come to Chicago and get it. And just because people live in Chicago and move somewhere and say, oh, I was this in Chicago, you don't know because you ain't never been there. But when you go to Chicago, you say, oh, no, he wasn't nothing like that because, man, them people over there are doing it. He ain't doing none of that. But just because you don't research it and he say, I'm from Chicago, that's what it is. No.
So... Right, what's going on in here? I know that's right. What's up, Carlton? Who was that said want to know what's going on? Carlton want to know what's going on in here. Some stuff, Carlton. You know, I kidnapped him because we in San Antonio, and I'm doing a parking lot pimping with him because he has a lot of questions. He has a lot of things that he always be saying, and I have to have questions answered.
Well, I'm answering them.
But I don't know if I really agree.
Okay, well, that's your opinion, though.
This is true.
You don't have to agree with me. But you will.
I understand it. Okay. Because there's so many areas that this, that, like you just said, this dance has reached so many different areas. Mm-hmm. Some of your smaller areas don't have the advantages of being able to even pick up. Some people can't afford to be able to just pick up and go to Chicago and get this dance. But they want to do it socially. Okay, and then they start traveling, going to some of these big sets, and they start to see people like you.
They get them at they start where?
Well, right. They start traveling and start going to some of these bigger sets.
Well, not traveling to Chicago. We got sets every day of the week, twice on Sundays.
I get it.
Okay.
So you're trying to tell me the only way to get this dance is through Chicago?
Yeah, I mean, you're going to learn things as you're going, but to get it, you got to come there. Let me ask you, you love Drew, right?
I do.
You got that. Where'd Drew get it from? Where'd Theo get it from? Where did they go? They didn't stay and wait for it to stay in Detroit. They came to Chicago and got it.
I am because you just have so many people that have popped up. Pat Clay, if they want, okay. So if teaching doesn't match what made learn, wait, that went by fast. Hold on. Learn this dance. That's the clue. To learn the dance. That's the clue. Yeah, Pat. I mean, I get it. It's just so many variables with this that is making it very difficult.
I'm it's not honest. Difficult. It's really not difficult.
I think it is.
It's really not difficult.
Okay.
Because first of all, we gotta stop putting people on pedestals that shouldn't be there. And I'm not saying because they can dance, we just dancers. We not heavy hitters. We just people that like to dance. Y'all gave us this title. If I'm walking down the street, you say, "Hey, I'm here," ain't nobody gonna turn around. Mm-hmm. Tick, Shawnee, Pat, Dickie, Vicky. I mean, you can just know there's so many people in Chicago that can really dance that you don't even know about.
Mm-hmm. So y'all don't give yourselves these names?
No. Not at all.
What about
But see, when you got people, I mean, I understand people promote themselves and all that, but when you promote yourself and put yourself on this pedestal like you arrive, you're going to get broke down. All the way down. There's always something to learn. Hell, I learn every day. Me and Tick do class. I'm with him every day. Man, show me to do that. I see Westside Mike do something. I see Cliff, Big Slim, Renner. I don't care who you are. If you can dance, you got something, I want it. When you get to your level, you think you all that, and you make these hot-ass flyers, and you promote yourself around the country, you're going to do a takeover? No, that shit don't happen. That shit don't happen. No. You get with people. You get with the people, and if the people, you know, say, okay, he's arrived, he this, he that, you don't go on and self-proclaim yourself to be something.
Okay,
no.
But if people are supporting you and people are following you and mm-hmm. you have a following and mm-hmm. you have a lot of views on your video, mm-hmm. that does make you a heavy hitter.
What is a heavy hitter? Somebody hit the bags hard? Somebody hit hard? Huh? A good fighter? Quiet as a church mouse on Sunday. I'm just curious.
I'm just saying. If you got some
We're just
flyers,
people that can dance.
Because that's
and
just
we might
how
be
bad
dancing.
It has gotten,
We
dog.
Might be
I'm
dancing
saying,
longer than some people.
That has got It has gotten that bad around this country. And some of y'all need to step up and say something. Y'all ain't saying that
Well,
bad.
Hold on. No matter what we say, y'all keep spending the money over there to make them think they're that way. Stop spending the money. Stop spending the money over there to make stop making them people feel that they're there if they're not there. You know?
I have never been speechless.
I'm just saying, for instance, I was somewhere and I seen people giving privates for $25. Okay, if that's what you want to do, that's your choice. But you got other people that's credible, they might charge $50 for their private. So if you go over there for that $25 private, you might get 10 cents worth of message. People doing things, they call themselves undercutting people from doing things and making it even worse. But guess what? We got people that you say is making it confusing, spending the money over there. I ain't mad because they paying him. I ain't mad at him for getting the I haven't gave Gina $25 and I don't know what the hell she gave me.
Well, people are dying from the
lies. Well, dying.
Did somebody just call him a false prophet?
that's just what it is.
I mean, I don't know what the solution is to this. I clearly y'all understand what I'm saying? It's a lot of it's going on. Cheryl is on here just laughing out loud, just a big bowl. Because it's happening all over, and I just don't. It needs to be addressed. I don't know how to address it.
And here's something so crazy, because I had a guy to come to me. He wanted to do a private. Then he was going to, I said, man, let me just tell you something. Stop running around all these people trying to do these privates, spend this money over there. Go back to your instructor get everything your instructor giving you. When you can't get no more, then go to the next person. That instructor will tell you, I told that person that.
But that's an instructor that you are endorsing.
No, I'm not endorsing. Why? If you in this instructor's class every week, but you running around here trying to, you're going to be messed up.
But what if it's an instructor that they're going to that they shouldn't be getting instruction from? Would you tell them that?
Yes, I would. In a heartbeat. And look, who going to whip my ass? Nobody. Nobody. If you ask me a question, I'm going to tell you, you're wasting your money over there. When I stopped my classes a couple of years ago, I put even if you come to me faithfully, if you go somewhere else, I ain't mad at you because you work for that money. But if you go somewhere bad, I'm like, oh, that's a bad move, but I hope you have fun. Learn something. Yeah.
Well, y'all give me thumbs up if you guys are good on connection right now, because I'm getting an indication that we may have a low connection. So give me thumbs up the connection has been good. Because I think it may be picking up the Wi-Fi from the hotel. So give me thumbs up that your connection is still good. So we'll wait for a minute. Thumbs up that the connection is still good. So we'll wait, because I do not want to miss that. I don't want you guys to miss anything. So it's still, people still coming in, so it must be still good. Okay. All right. So it's nothing we can do to try to combat some of this bad teaching that we're getting.
Yes, you can.
We're good.
Yeah, okay. No. Yes, you can. It's something you can do. Stop taking your money over there.
But they're at these...
Stop taking your money over there. If you know it's bad, why are you going
to... But hold you on. Might not know it's bad.
You just said ain't well, nothing yeah, to do about that. That. Yeah. So that's like Wendy's. Wendy's got a bad chicken sandwich. You going to keep on and buy it? No. You going to be like, I ain't buying that. That's bad. And you going to tell everybody else too.
But they got fans.
Yeah. Okay, well... Sooner or later, they fans gonna wake up and say, hey, this ain't it. Sooner or later, the fans will wake up and say, this ain't it.
Does anybody feel what I'm trying? I'm trying to say things without saying things.
Not what's said. Look, you want the parking lot pimp? Say what you got to say.
Don't sugarcoat it.
Yes, you can text me. I'll say it.
Okay, well, this my phone right now.
Oh, well, you're in trouble. You're in trouble.
People on the live can say it. Y'all can say it.
Stop saying.
Well, I mean, I know people spending their money with false prophets, but I don't think they really know that they're false prophets.
They know.
You understand what I'm saying?
You want me to tell you why they know? Because they heard the whispers. People around them, why are you going over there? You know that? Mm-mm. And I ain't saying I'm the best instructor, because I still learn as I go. I teach where you at. I'm going to take you up. But it might be something I don't know. I'm going to get it, though. Hey, Tick, where you at? Man, look, I need to get this. Daryl Davis, where you at? See, I go to the old school. I go anybody. Shawnee's, what you got? You got something going? When I get down there, where you at? Let me see this again. I'll make them do a move 300 times. If it takes me 301 times to get it, I'm going to keep doing it.
Well, let me say this. All good dancers are not a good instructor.
I agree with that 100%. But to be a good instructor, you got to
come. Somebody personally, as a good instructor,
you personally still are learning. I don't know everything, and if I give you everything I got, then I ain't got nothing else to show you. So I got to go out here and seek and learn and create
but
to give you
more.
But
then know how to teach it. Everybody don't know how to teach it.
Didn't I say everybody can't teach it? And if you can't break it all the way, if you got a person in there that just can't get nothing, but if you can break it all the way down, that light bulb going to click on, oh, this is what you've been trying to tell me to do. But if you just say you can't do that, why I can't do it? Because you just got to do it this way. And that's a lot of these instructors out there. You just got to do it this way. They can't tell you why you can't do it, but you just got to do it this way.
What about the instructors that actually just go into class and they just do moves with you? That's bad you're too. You know why? And they just doing moves and combinations.
Because
they
if they not, if they ain't, if they doing moves and combination, then that's what you must want. Because if they ain't looking at your feet, your body language, your hand, if they ain't looking at your position, they ain't doing you no good.
But does that mean they don't really know the dance?
That means that they ain't caring about the dance. They teaching you a move. That's all they want to teach you is move. They don't care how you get through. If you get through the move all right, okay, that's it. They move to that. Hell no. That ain't it with me. Your feet ain't right. Your body position is bad. Your head turns that way. It should be turned this way. Your arm's too flabby. It's way up here. Come on now. You got to look at all that to correct. You got to correct your basic before you can take it any further. If that, if they foundation is right, they're going to follow everything you want to give. Then now you can teach them how to do this, how to do that. But if that foundation is right, you got to teach the foundation. That, now, one good dancer out there didn't have a strong foundation. Because that's what we build off of, our foundation. Everything you see out here comes off our foundation. All these great dancers have a strong foundation. They can create out of it, drop of it. Come on now.
What's the solution to fixing some of this garbage?
Stop spending the money over there with their asses. Let me ask you something. How long can a person teach if he ain't got no students? I'm just asking. For instance, we down here at the chocolate bar. We got an instructor in here. He had on a shirt, instructor. No, you ain't running this one. You ain't running this one. Right? Am I lying?
Oh,
right?
Why did he?
Right. So, what could you learn from him?
Oh.
Nothing. I made somebody go dance with him, and I said, I want you to dance with him, and don't you hold up. I want you to walk that 7-8 up. I want you to dance, do your body. I want you to do everything on him. When she did that, you know what he did? He stood there and looked at her. But you're an instructor. Stop giving these people hope that they know what they're doing. And he going to tell me, my student. I said, man, your student? You can't have no students. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know I did it. You seen it.
Whose car is this?
I don't know. He was in my workshop. I just took it. His keys.
I've never been in a parking lot pimping, and I'm supposed to. Actually, the premise of my parking lot pimping, I actually kidnap the people and I bring y'all in here and I ask y'all questions and put y'all in a situation where y'all are uncomfortable.
I'm
very uncomfortable right now.
That's on you. You ask the question, I'll tell you. Stop spending money with these people, then classes will shut down and they'll seek out the people they need. Mm-hmm. Keep getting them $10, $20, $15. Once you take that away, they'll find another hustle. And see, this shouldn't be a hustle. That's what they're doing. They're hustling. Why are they hustling? Because they're giving you shit that you can't use.
Oh, God.
Mm-hmm. And don't let them get in the contest. Oh, Lord. He's going to pass. He's going to have a mega church class. Because he's in the contest.
Nobody probably called my name just then, did they? Nobody probably even know me out here.
They might.
Did he just say a mega church class?
Yeah.
Because they were in the contest?
Yeah, what? Go ahead and have flyers and everything. World's largest no place contestant. Stop boosting their class ratings up. Stop it.
We're fading out. Yeah. So you got security. Marlon Brown said he's your security.
See there?
Yeah, the phone is up in the window, so it may be getting hot because of the Texas heat. So we're going to get out of the car in a moment, but I don't know if the doc has anything else he wants to say. You got to
stop spending the money.
I'm at a point where... What's up, Bang? I'm at a point where... The connection is crazy. Yeah, I'm dead too. I pulled it out of the window. I'm hoping that'll help. I think it's the heat. I had the phone actually up in the window, so I'm holding it now.
Is the air hitting the back of it?
Yeah, I got the air hitting it. Mm-hmm. Hopefully that'll cool it off because it is hot in Texas, baby. So hopefully that'll help. But I don't know. We're gonna get out of the car because I don't even know if I want to talk to Doc anymore while we're in Texas. Because
I told the truth.
But you didn't have to bring up an instructional video.
Because the people will, they'll start coming out. They will start coming out. Now, you heard it here first. Now, the first one you see, please call me and tell me the doctor's an instructional video out. What's up, Drew? What's happening, buddy?
He done tore up my telephone. My phone is straight frying right now. It don't even want to connect. I'm not even on the Wi-Fi. I'm on Sprint, and Sprint don't even want to work. It's like, uh-uh. Doc doing way too much.
Doc telling the truth.
I get it, Doc, but you doing too much, I think.
I'm telling the truth. Dean Ferris said, bang!
He is keeping it real, but I think you're going to hurt some feelings, though. Because
well, you know what? You got to have thick skin when you're doing something. When you got the public into your business, you got to have thick skin because everybody's not going to like what you do. Everybody don't like what I do. I don't give a damn because they don't like it. What they don't like, somebody else do. And that's same with the other people. I don't like it, but it ain't, you know, they ain't paying no bills or nothing over there. And I ain't going to pay no bills over there. But if you keep saying, how do we stop the madness, stop spending the money. Plain and simple.
They said my Sprint service is scared as well. It's straight up tripping.
No, it's just...
Well, they said, no, this needs to be done. Carlton said this does need to be done.
Okay.
Now, listen, this is what I want to make sure happens, though. I think even with this show, I've had several people come on here, mm-hmm. and we've talked. What can we do to facilitate change, though? Is there anything? I understand what you said.
Stop spending the money. I guarantee you it's going to be a change. Stop taking the money over there. Watch how dramatically it changed me.
Yeah, it's there a little bit, so we'll see. We'll see how long it'll let us stay, but I think my phone got too hot, so I don't know. But he spoke the truth, I guess. But guys, I guess we'll have to just stop spending the money. And why are you laughing about it?
Because it's the truth.
It's not funny, though.
It's the truth.
You got a lot of people that spend a lot of money on some of these classes.
What's the first thing I said you should do before you spend your money? Okay.
Only instructional video I've seen in my 10 years of stepping are by Larry Collins out of Detroit.
Trust me, there'll be some more real soon.
Baby, there are some out there that are just absolutely amazing.
Oh, it is some. I tell you want to. Let's talk about that. Since you know about them. Is it worthy? How much are they? At least you can tell me how much the price of the video. Stop spending the money.
They're $20.
Oh. Okay. Wow.
I think they're $20 for like 30 minutes or 45 minutes. Cheaper than a private.
But it's cheaper than a private. You're right. That's another $20 you done threw away. What you going to learn in a videotape? Especially if it came out today. Because let me just say, the people that might be doing them today probably don't have 2 years worth of experience.
Why? The amount of shade that you're throwing right now.
I'm not throwing shade.
You're throwing shade, and I feel
that. Let me tell you
something. I just feel that. I don't know.
I'm not throwing shade. I just say this here. I'm not going to get into nothing that I can't give you everything about it. And when I don't know, I'm going to get it to bring it back.
Did somebody just ask me who Really? Cheryl, really? Did you just ask me who these video? Really?
I want to know too, Cheryl. Hold on, what's Cheryl saying? Roll that down.
Cheryl wants to know who's the video. Who the instructor? I don't know.
Well, I want to know.
I can't think of the names right now.
Where
the
they from?
The names escape
Hold on.
Me.
Where they from?
I don't remember.
Oh, that's somebody you know well then.
I don't remember. That's I know a lot of people.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm with you, Cheryl.
I think I may have them on the show at some point.
But can you give everybody a personal phone call and let us know they're going to be on there? I guarantee. You think it's burning up now? And when you put them on the show, make sure you got some video playing.
Really, Carlton? He said he's dancing and singing. Say it. Everybody's asking, Cheryl. No, it's nobody but you and Doc that's asking. Nobody else is asking. No, Helen, don't do that. Really? Really, Helen? I'm not going to say because I don't want to say. I just don't want to say.
Well, then, you know what? You shouldn't even be internet host then. If you can't tell
no.
us, we like Jerry Springer over here. You and Atway going to start some shit. You and Tony Atway
Now, Tony will start. Now, he will do it. I tried to
how to do it. Come on, do it.
I just would rather be in the middle. Let you guys find out for yourself.
Right, them the people that had. Okay. Pete had one. Mac 3 had one. Come on now. Who else? And them old tapes, that, by the way. So I see what you're saying. Them old. We talking about the new ones. Don't you want to know, Cheryl?
No, you don't.
Give me a thumbs up, Cheryl, if you want to know.
The reason why I won't say who it is because I have not personally seen the tapes. Once I'm able to actually see the tapes and actually be able to endorse the tapes, then I will actually say the names of these tapes. But once I'm able...
Cheryl said, read your thread. Everybody is asking. Cheryl, give
once
me a thumbs up.
Once I'm able to see... Okay, so yeah, you'll see it's a little bit behind. So actually, okay, so we don't know. It is a recent tape, so you see it's a little bit behind.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, so Cheryl knows who it is. Well, who is it, Cheryl?
Theo.
My man, Theo.
Well, I'm glad you guys are there.
We're back.
Patiently waiting. So you guys were patiently waiting. Yeah, it's no longer a parking lot. We're actually in a room now because apparently we ruffled some feathers. Well, he did. I didn't. I'm just going to be, you know, I haven't ruffled any feathers because, you know. Good afternoon, Sheila. Because, you know, I try to stay neutral.
I'm neutral.
No, you weren't neutral.
I'm neutral.
No.
Stop spending the money. That's neutral. Whether it's me or whoever, which I know they were spending money. But no.
So we're going to wait a little bit, let folks get signed back on. Hello. Make sure you guys share this live real quick. We're going to wait just a little bit. So make sure you hit share right now. Because we're back.
What you put in this, huh?
I haven't touched your cup.
Don't blame me.
I have not touched your cup. Make sure you hit share right now, please. Go ahead and hit share because Doc is clearly on one today. Or two.
It's the alcohol.
He doesn't even drink. Hey, Tony Doc. Now you know somebody done called Tony.
Tony, my man.
Somebody done called Tony and woke Tony up.
And you know what Tony's saying? God damn that damn Doc beat me to it.
Tony, I wish you was on here earlier because he was showing out in the car. She was showing out in the car. It's part two. He was showing out in the car. My phone like almost blew up.
That's because you ain't paid the bill.
That's true. I don't think they turn you off on the weekends.
Oh, yeah, they do.
They do?
Mm, I heard.
We give a little time for people to log back on, so.
You know, this big Tony Dial on there. I know I'm famous now. I got Tony on there watching.
Sorry. Y'all ready? Because we're going straight in. We're going to go right in where we left off at.
Do you remember?
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, let's go then.
The last thing I remember you saying is...
Stop spending the money.
Right.
Stop spending the money.
And if you're just now joining us, let's bring you back up to date. So what we're talking about is the people that have these classes that they're teaching all over the country. And these classes that they're teaching, they are teaching these classes based on these digital flyers that they have out, and the fact that they have YouTube videos that have quite a few viewers. And that gives them the right to be able to teach classes, and they have wonderful marketing.
Just so, because they got good marketing and they got a video or out there that gives them a right to teach a class?
I'm just letting the folks know where we left off at.
Ah. But your question was to me was, how do we stop? Tony Dow, she asked me, how do we stop the shenanigans at these so-called instructors that's giving bad information? And my answer is, stop spending the money with them. The class with hope. Plain and simple.
This is my thing. And this was my comeback to that. I don't think the people necessarily know that they're not getting good information.
They do.
And that's your response each time.
You know why I say that? Because if you didn't know, somebody told you around in your circle.
But what if they somebody all got bad told, information? They could all have bad information.
And they told.
They all.
It's whispered. It's whispered around the circle. If you didn't hear it from your crew, you heard it from the outside. You didn't heard it from somebody else. So now, if you heard it, you need to investigate. Why are they saying this? You might. Oh, he was good to me. Well, let me check out. Too many people have said that. Let me check it out. Let me find out for myself. What's really going on?
We were just talking about, we were talking to some other people as we were coming up to try to get part two started. Mm-hmm. And we were saying the whole thing about the fact that it's not anything that's really legitimized about this dance. And I think that's some of the confusion with it, because you have people like yourself and some of your people that's been in this dance a very, very long time that teach this dance. And you guys stand on the principle of, we're teaching it right. You understand? And so you have people that, you know, have great marketing, may have reached out, and they're going to take over certain regions and things of that nature. And they're going to bring that there.
You was going there, you got lost for words. You don't even know what to say behind that. When you said take over and great marketing, yeah, they might have great marketing skills and all that, but does that make them a good instructor? Does that make them, because they got good marketing skills, does that make them a good instructor? Your body of work gives you that. For instance, here's a scenario. Have you ever been in Tony Dow's basement?
No, I haven't had the pleasure.
Have you ever had lessons by Tony Dow?
Yes.
Okay. Before you had lessons, what have you heard about Tony Dow?
That he was one of the best.
And they all started where?
Chicago.
And his basement.
In his basement, correct.
So he done turned out a whole bunch of people. So if Tony Dow was in class, would you go to Tony Dow because you heard his name? Right. Why? Because of the body of work that everybody said.
Right.
So if these people don't have a body of work, they've been in the game 1 and 2 years, what could they possibly teach you? They at the level you at. What can they teach you?
Okay, let me say this.
What can they teach you?
You're right, but let me say this. Guys, make sure you share this live, because this is some good information. So make sure you share. Now, I know for me, when I first got into the dance, mm-hmm. there's a certain amount of intimidation too mm-hmm. that new dancers face when it comes to this dance. When we see you guys, mm-hmm. you say you guys don't give your names these titles, and I get it. But we look at you guys, you know, we see these videos and y'all in these contests, and we think you guys are just the absolute best. So there's a certain amount of intimidation. So we're a little bit hesitant to come to you and say, ooh, I would like to do, you're starstruck. I mean, because it's a dance.
When you actually meet us, then you got a whole different.
You're great.
You got a whole different.
You're great. I get it.
You know, okay, he's good. Then he's been generous. He's been showing me this. I'm going to his class and that. Mm-hmm. But just because they put us on a pedestal don't mean we think we there. Mm-hmm. We just like to have fun and we like to see people get it the right way. And enjoy it. First and foremost, you need to enjoy this. You need to enjoy it. If you're not enjoying it, why do it?
I think there's a disconnect. I'm gonna be honest with you.
It is a disconnect.
There's a major disconnect between your level, mm-hmm. the people that are considered your intermediate, and the beginners.
Where's the disconnect?
There's a major disconnect between the beginners and your level.
Here's where the disconnection is at right here. The disconnect is that you put us so far up on this pedestal that y'all afraid to approach us or y'all afraid to get by us. And when I do workshops all over, I tell people all the time, I would love to dance with each and every last one of y'all. I would love to have a conversation with y'all. But it's so many of y'all, I'm not going to be able to come get you one by one. But if you see me, grab me, mm-hmm. talk to me, dance with me, I have no problem. I never would say no. Let's go. Mm-hmm. Let's go. And it's a lot of, everybody's like that. Just because y'all put us on this pedestal don't mean we're assholes. So.
I agree, David. Definitely great marketing skills and all that definitely mm-hmm. doesn't make you a great right. dancer. However, marketing has always sold anything. I'm sorry.
But then
great
guess
marketing
what?
Has always sold.
And then guess what?
A product.
It has.
And so,
then,
I
and
mean,
they
so
end up failing after the, once they find out about it. The product.
I get it, but it's going to sell. So mm-hmm. when you have yourself, people like yourself and, you know, you guys, you know, y'all make it feel, you make some of these people feel really bad that they've gone to some of these places.
Well, no.
Y'all don't do it like mm-hmm. that.
Because you woke up, now you came to get it. You came to get it. I really don't have no problem. Yeah, I ain't going to lie. I really don't have a problem with no instructor. I don't have a problem when I just dislike his ways. But outside of that, I don't stop nobody from getting no money. But if you come to me and say, well, I learned this in such and such class, come on back over there. Because this is how I do things over here. If you can't do it in my format, then go on back over there because that's why you left in the first place. I don't teach you how to dance with me. I'm never going to teach you how to dance with me. But I am going to teach you how to dance with anybody that touches your hand. That's what you want to do. Because I'm not going to be at every party you at and you looking for me to dance with. No, I need you to touch every hand you possibly can touch to get a different feel because everybody's feel is different.
Why does this dance look so different? Why does the dance look so different? Why does it look so different? From somebody from Chicago, from somebody from Detroit, from somebody from Texas, from somebody from Atlanta, why does it look so different and it's
the same freaking dance?
Why does it look so different?
What should never look different is your foundation should always be there. Your basic should be there, period. I don't care how you do, your basic should be right there. That way we know where you're at. I can hold your mom and tell you when we start out, okay, well, she can't do all this. Let me challenge her, but not take her over the top. Mm-hmm. I know where you at. So long as you have your basics, the dance look different from your personality that you put in your dance, not your foundation of that step. That's going to always be the same. What makes the dance different is when you add your personality into it. I don't dance different from Tony Dye. I don't dance different from Tick and all that. We all got the same foundation, but what makes us different is because we put our personality to it. That's what makes it look different.
Okay, let's go there for a second. And this is no this is no dagger toward the men at all.
Mm-hmm.
At all. It seems that the women in this dance continue to strive to get better.
They go to class. They go to a class.
Okay.
So here's the thing. Like I just said in my workshop today, I made the women, I asked the women, who go to class the most? We do, they said. I said, who learn all the moves? We do. Who make the men bad? Y'all do. Why? Because you go to class, you learn these moves, and the moment he raise your hand and you think you recognize the move, instead of you letting him lead you into it, you're going to do it for him. So now he thinks he's got it, but when he get with somebody else that ain't going to help him, now he looking at her talking about she can't dance that good because she missed this move, she missed that move, and she can't do this. No, she's not helping you like the other 85 women did. That's the real of it.
So women.
Y'all bad too. Y'all bad because y'all won't let them lead. So when you don't let them lead and you helping them, they arrive now because they got the moves down pat. But then they go somewhere else that this woman ain't going to help him. Now he figured, man, she's trying to make you look bad. She don't even want to do, she ain't following my lead. You ain't let her. You just held your hand up. Just for instance, if I'm dancing with you, I hold your hand up. First thing you finna do is take off turning. I ain't gave you no signal. I just held your hand up. What that mean is something going to happen. You don't know when, but it's going to happen. But no, Miss Helpful Annie here going to do the turn for him. There it is.
Because most men need help.
But
because they're not going to class.
But you know how you know how you really, if they need help, you know how you can really help them?
How?
By not helping them. Then they'll see that they need more help than they thought they did. Oh, let me tell you.
This is too much pressure. It's too much pressure in this dance. I'm just going to be honest. It's too much pressure.
Dancing.
We got to be
cute. I was getting in the contest.
We can't help y'all. It's too much.
I was getting in the contest in 2012. So I'm like, you know, I'm pretty good. I know I'm finna do it, right? I tell my man, come on out here and help me, man. You know, see what you see and this and that and other. Every year I tell Tick, man, come see Owen when he was here with me. Do you know when he came out there to help me, I wanted to quit dancing?
Wow, why?
Because he had me do one simple move that I couldn't get. The whole day, I was like, you know what? I ain't doing it no more. I went home, went to sleep. At 3 o'clock in the morning, I jumped up. I said, you dumbass.
I got it.
He just wants you to do this. So sometimes you need that naked eye to come in and help you and make you realize something that you don't know that you thought you knew.
Mm-hmm.
I would ask anybody. Daryl, man, look, I'm having a problem with this. Daryl, man, come on down here. Yeah, Cliff Reynolds. Cliff, I can't, man, I'm having a problem with this carousel. Oh, man, I got it from Drew. Let me show you how to do this. Got it.
Do you think the humbleness is gone from the dance? Like,
yeah. 50-50. Because I see a lot of people that are really humble. Mm-hmm. I see a lot of people that is there that shouldn't be there. Mentally, they there, but they're there. Yeah.
I've seen that a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen a lot of people, a lot of men that they think they're like really good.
Mm-hmm.
And they feel horrible.
Is it after the contest?
You get something to drink as you're asking
me? Oh, yeah. You don't mind me drinking on your show, do you?
No, I don't.
My wife won't kill. They gonna kill me. I don't even drink and I'm drinking.
I'm just... No, it's usually they, it's, yeah.
It's after that.
Mm-hmm.
That's when they come with their mega church class.
Yeah.
Get a pound. Certify people, I guess, huh?
We've tried that. I've brought that up before on the show that I don't think that's going to work.
Probably won't.
Because at the end of the day, let's go business.
Because probably won't.
If I want to start a class,
mm-hmm.
and I have the ability to start a class, I can start a class.
You're going
to
start it.
You don't have the right to tell me that I can't.
And I got that.
Right?
Yeah.
If I want to do that, I have great marketing. Listen, I got a studio.
And if you got your people coming there, I'm with that too, because you're bringing people that probably, you're probably bringing people that don't step to it.
Right.
So now you're bringing new faces to it.
Okay.
And I ain't mad at that. Because sooner or later, they're going to say, oh, no, this ain't what it is. Let me go over there.
Okay.
You shut down soon.
Did you just slurp?